Grieving mother Mariam Nansubuga, together with her three children, was heading to Kampala, where she had planned to spend a night at her sister's home before proceeding to Iganga to visit her sick father. The bus was moving at a high speed. I heard a loud bang. From that moment, I became unconscious. I lost my three children in the accident. A few minutes into Fort Portal City, Nansubuga says the bus was moving at a high speed. She heard a loud bang like the bus had hit something, and chaos ensued. Nansubuga is among the more than 57 passengers who survived the deadly accident that claimed the lives of 21 people. The bus belonging to the Link Bus Company veered off the road at Sebitori in Kabarole District on Wednesday before overturning several times. Nansubuga says she looked for her children inside the bus but could not find them until she was helped outside the bus and saw their dead bodies. The children are 13-year-old Gift Asimwe, 3-year-old Devin Bubezi, and 2-month-old Destine Alinda. I failed to trace my children until I was helped by some good Samaritans around the scene. Geoffrey Bitamidwa, the father of the deceased children who visibly looked shocked, says he escorted his wife and children to the bus stage in Bundibujo town before waving them goodbye. A few hours later, Bitamidwa says he received a phone call from an unknown person telling him about the accident and death of his three children. Nansubuga is currently nursing wounds she sustained from the accident at Fort Portal Regional Referral Hospital.
After 2 weeks, then she will have entered another stage which requires now another kind of intervention because she will be developing depression.
On Thursday, the Fort Portal Regional Referral Hospital revealed that lack of a CT scan had inconvenienced them in giving the treatment to accident victims.
PTSD is post-traumatic stress disorder. It's also a mental illness which tends to follow time when somebody has gone through fatal accident or life-threatening event.
Meanwhile, the transport fares from Fort Portal to Kampala have increased by 20,000 shillings to 40,000 shillings per person following the suspension of Link Bus Company license by the government. On Thursday yesterday, the State Minister for Works and Transport, Musa Echweru, visited the scene where the accident happened and told journalists that the government had suspended the company's license.
We are suspending the, because you see, apart from this investigation, we also want our teams, our experts, to look at the whole fleet of those buses in that particular company to see whether they are mechanically sound. That's not to suggest that this one may have been mechanically deficient. But we are just saying, let's suspend that first. And if we find that this was a unique case, then we shall put them back on the road. But that has happened.
Edward Akankwasa, the manager of Baby Coaches, says with Link Bus currently suspended, they are overwhelmed by the number of passengers. Some of the passengers were found at Baby Coach Terminal. They say they were stranded and willing to pay any amount to get onto the bus. However, others describe the actions by the government to suspend the operations of Link Bus Company as unfair to their journeys and plans. Report by Jonan Tusingwire for the news.